Welcome to another episode of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. This is Swetha Mannepalli, your host. Today, I have the privilege to sit with Lakshmi Ponnurasan, who is one of our MVPs. Lakshmi, do you want to introduce yourself?
Absolutely. Thank you so much for having me here. Hey there, my name is SanthanaLakshmi. I'm a Microsoft MVP from the data platform category, and I specialize in Power BI. I am a data analyst in the Institutional Effectiveness Department at Missouri University of Science and Technology. And most of my day revolves around exploring data, building insights, and being amazed at what Power BI can do.
Wonderful, Lakshmi. Before we get into all the goodness that you have for us today, I want to sort of take a step back and understand how you became an MVP, what motivated you to, you know, become one. Did you get some inspiration from somewhere? If you want to share a little bit about yourself, becoming an MVP, it will really help our, you know, guests tuning in.
Absolutely. So becoming an MVP was not like a dream for me, but it was something that came along my journey. I was always passionate about sharing my content, sharing things that I learned with the community. And when I was awarded the MVP, and MVPs are basically decided on the basis of how much you contribute, what is the impact you have on people, and that's how I became my MVP. And yes, I have lots and lots of people who are my inspiration. Like when I see Patrick and Adam on stage, the way they talk, leave aside the technical content, just the way they talk, the way they are so down to earth, humbles me.
Wonderful. No, plus one to that humbleness, that they, I get inspired by them every day.
Absolutely.
So amazing. Now, what I would love to cover in this episode, Lakshmi, is I want folks to understand what it takes to be part of community, and where would you start? Let's say I am either net new to data or net new to Microsoft Fabric. If I want to be an MVP or a super user, or as a matter of fact, just explore all the resources, all the goodness that we have, bringing this community together. Because if you really think about it, Power BI started with a community. It's for the community, by the community, and today we are really building on the same platform for Microsoft Fabric. So if anybody wants to be part of this community, where would they start? What are all the resources that are available for them today, please?
Yes, absolutely. So the best way to start being a part of the community is just going to the Fabric community on the Microsoft website. Once you go on there, on the top, you will find a lot of tabs wherein you can see forums, you can find galleries for inspiration, you can find places where you can submit your ideas, vote for the ideas, look into the Fabric roadmap, and a very good place to for all the beginners to go, check out what are the free events that Microsoft are organizing, and stay updated.
Wonderful. Before you get started, Lakshmi, I want to share some fun facts about Lakshmi. She was our first Power BI Data Viz World Championship US edition winner last year. No, it was this year in Vegas. So yeah, that could be an inspiration for most of you all to be part of that competition and, you know, take it up a notch. Yeah. Now, Lakshmi, I would love for you to take us through the journey. Like I said, at Fabric Tech Talk Fridays, we just don't do the talk, we walk the talk. I want you to please share where anybody interested in being part of this would start their journey and be part of the community. If there are any resources that you would like to share, all the goodness that you have today for us.
Absolutely. So let's start with the Dashboard in a Day. This is where I started learning Power BI. So Dashboard in a Day is a one-day hands-on workshop for all the new Power BI users, and even can be attended by all the Power BI users who want to refresh their knowledge. All you have to do is click register now. You have a list of all the events that pop up according to dates and times. You can filter them according to format. You can filter them according to topics, products, or even language. Once you are happy with the time and the date, all you have to do is go ahead and click registration and details. You will see a registration page open up. Type in your details, hit register, and it's as simple as that. You will get an email confirming. Since I am very new to Fabric, I used Fabric Analyst in a Day in order to get used to Fabric, and it was a great start. It's similar to Dashboard in a Day, where you go select your event according to your date and time and hit registration. let's talk about the fabric community. So this is where you can go learn about anything about fabric, anything about Power BI databases. This is the page where I go on a regular basis. You will find forums on the top, different forums for different tools. You have inspiration galleries. You have places where you can submit your ideas, vote for ideas as well. Communities where you can join a user group. You can become a user group. Let's walk through the contest page. So this is the community contest page, which is updated whenever there's a new contest that comes up. The winners are posted here regularly. You can also find inspiration right here. Now, we are going to do a quick look about all the challenges that took place in the month of August. There were four amazing challenges that took place in August. The Power BI DataWiz World Champs Europe Edition. We had the Fabric Notebooks competition. We had the Translytical Task Flow contest and also the sticker contest. Quickly going to show you what are the contributions the Fabric members made. The community members went crazy and submitted lots and lots of stickers. I will also show you the submission that I made. So this is the submission that I made for the Fabric sticker contest. Pretty cool, right? And then this is the Translytical Task Flow Gallery, wherein it's a very new concept, but you will see a lot of people submit in their ideas. This is a quick example of how you could submit ideas. So this was one of my ideas that I submitted. Very easy to add in text, add in a lot of images, explain what you were trying to do. And the best part, you can even add your code snippets so that anyone who's new to this concept can just copy, paste and replicate the scenario. Also, you see, there are 15 people who've kudoed my idea. So pretty good with that. This is the Power BI Contest Gallery, wherein you can submit all your Power BI reports. This is a quick example of the report that I created and submitted for the DataWiz Championship. People can look at these reports and get inspired. That's the main goal out of it. Also, I really love going to this contest gallery whenever I'm out of ideas. And this is the Power BI DataWiz World Champs US Edition blog, wherein this is John, he's the winner, and the four of us were the finalists. That's it.
Wonderful. So I must also admit that I started my Power BI journey with Dashboard in a Day long time ago. But again, great resources. If you are planning to start your Power BI journey or Microsoft Fabric journey, you have resources that Lakshmi shared with you today. The other thing I want to touch on is the ideas that Lakshmi mentioned. We take that very seriously. That's exactly what dictates our roadmap. The kudos that Lakshmi talked about. So the more kudos, which means more people are interested in having this idea. So it gets bumped up into our prioritization when our product teams really look at, hey, where do we go from here? What are the things that we want to focus on? So ideas page is what really drives our roadmap. So please take it seriously. If you have an idea, if you have a burning question, if you're from a developer delighted developer experiences perspective, if you are interested in sharing something that really bothers you, even the littlest of the things, we take them seriously from a product roadmap perspective. So yeah, that's one thing that I wanted to call out. But again, Lakshmi, before we end the session, I really wanted to understand from your perspective, what did Fabric or being part of the community did to you, both personally as well as professionally?
Yes, so I'm very happy to share about this. So what I've realized is Microsoft is not just about technology, it's more about the community as well. So from basic Dashboard in a Day workshops to FabCon, such a great event, from Power BI contests, sticker contests, so basically it has everything for anyone who wants to participate. And I've been taking part in these contests very regularly. And one of my proudest moments was I was one of the finalists of the Power BI DataWiz Championship US edition. And the best part is this not only helped me build network, helped me gain confidence in my skills, and I was even able to make a career move. So what are you guys waiting for? You should be a part of the community and see what wonders it could do.
The call to action here is pretty clear. In my mind, take that, you know, faith, leap of faith is what we call. If you are really planning to start your Fabric journey, do not wait another day. Today is your day to take that step forward and change. You know, it changed my life for good. And I'm pretty sure there are many stories, many people that can share and attest to this. So yeah, with that, thank you so much, Lakshmi, for hanging out with us today. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Swetha.